Link Up TV, what is good? I go by the name of Chris DiCapo. You know the vibes. Right now, it's a South London United Link Up. I'm surrounded by two legends, two of the greats. On my left, your little niggas ain't greasy at all. You're new to the beef. I've been beefing since school. Tiny Boost.
Thanks, bro. That was nice.
On my right, choo. What you say, Youngs? Choo, choo. Youngs Teflon, two legends in the building. What's good?
Damn, man.
Good, how you doing? What's good?
All good, man. let's talk about something straight off the jump, yeah? The state of UK rap. From the top of the head, what would you both say? How do you feel the UK rap scene is like right now?
Overall, it's in a good place. Man, them are coming off the roads and getting money and living a dream, like, almost. People are touring. People are doing mad shows. People are doing all sorts. So you can't really complain. I'll be a hater.
Boy, I'd agree with the statement overall. Like successive wise, yeah. Like and people being able to like change their situations, yeah. And it's a good. It's in a good place. Creatively though, I wouldn't say it's. It don't match up creatively because I feel like money-wise and success-wise and whatnot, it's like a higher ceiling now for everyone. Yeah. Like before, there might be a one man that was doing it or two man. Now you can have at least 10 men, all arguably in their own spots up there.
Would some say it's better that the masses are kicking down the doors? Would you say that's
100% because it makes it better for me, it makes it better for you, for him. Like if I'm doing something where you can do similar or the same and come through, it makes it better for everyone. It makes the door bigger to go through.
All right, let's not sit safe with this. Because you both said...
No, I didn't finish though.
All right, don't do your thing.
I was saying, on that side of things, it's better than it's ever been. Yeah. But quality-wise and creative-wise, I don't think it is that. Because either men are trying to do what the man did to get through the door and you just sound like my man now. Or it's it's hard to explain, but creatively, no one's trying to be themselves. Like, what man was doing before when it come in the game is a whole total different thing. Man's trying to jump in this lane and that lane. And me personally, I'm...
What would you say are the popular sounds or popular things that you're seeing the people emulate?
Obviously, the melody thing and the drill thing is like the front runners for this thing. Mm. Or the drip kind of thing. That's okay. Like if you look like you're making a mad papers, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you don't necessarily have to be a good rapper. Image. Yeah, the image rap thing. Yeah. I don't even say drip because some man that can rap good and they still got whatever, good clothing. Mm. Like if that's how you wanna put it, you feel me? But yeah, the image rap and the rascal, image, drill and melody, they're the thing that's front running the thing, you hear me?
When do you feel like the originality within the UK rap scene that died down?
When like everyone just I can't say following America here because at the end of the day rap hip hop is an American thing.
From, course, yeah? course.
But there was a time where we proper had our own that it was totally there's no similarity, there's certain, obviously they got English accent or whatever, but there's certain sounds and certain way men are doing their thing where it's like, that's common. You know what I'm trying to say? Even the slang.
The slang, alright, I was going to say that.
Yeah. Down to the slang from
Man will use slang in their raps that they're not using to talk to their brethren, you know? But because in a rap it sounds like...
You know what I'm saying? Like, so that's it's all crazy for me. Like, I don't even say certain things, really.
It's just not UK. You won't say that on a normal day today.
You feel me?
I can listen to it, my catalogue, I probably listen to more American music than English, but at the same time, you won't hear that in my music.
Yeah.
I'm always gonna, even me, man saying rod, drill and melodies, boom, man's jumped on drill beats. Mm. I started with garage, I've jumped on grime beats, bro, rap is my thing. When you talk about me, you're not talking about all that other stuff, because I still give you what I'm known for.
100%.
Whereas man will just float all over the place, and you lost yourself now. And I see it happening. I see it happening to some of my favorite artists. I'm talking. Cool. What you're saying is cool. We had our own style. I call it like the post gigs era.
Yes.
Obviously, man was rapping before gigs. Everyone was. You know what I mean? There's bare rappers like big up the old school, Skinny Man, Black Twang, them man there that was doing it. Rodney P, all of them, man. And obviously, that's not my era, but I know their names
and they exist.
Yeah, I'm not going to block them out of the convo. Yeah. But my thing is when gigs come on, gigs was talking the gangster shit.
Yeah,
he was talking the street shit. He was talking what man was actually doing in the streets and making it sound cool to rap it in the music. I'm going to be real, and you probably went through it as well. There's a time where man was living a certain way, where man's like late teens, early 20s, and you might not even want to rap it a certain way because you're actually living, so you're kind of trying to dumb it down. My man come and fuck that. Two Mac 10s, that's 50s, like, you know? And it's like, whoa, man, what did he say that? And he's getting played on radio and like, you know what? I'm gonna rap and rap how I wanna rap now. And that was like a, I can't remember what, I think this was from like 09, 010 onwards.
Like gigs kind of made it like, not even kind of, he made it like you wanna, he made you wanna rap from.
Yeah.
Like, he made you wanna, like a lot of man was rapping, like I've listened to a lot of man, but it wasn't until like, I heard like, obviously like when I was listening to 50 and all that, like G-Unit, all them things.
Can't resonate with it.
Like, I was resonating with what they're saying, but obviously, that's look, there you go.
It ain't close.
Exactly, it's not close, because there's certain slangs they might be saying, like.
And you wouldn't understand
that. I don't understand, but it sounds hard. Like you might hear Jada say, I'm going to get him with the hawk. Like,
I don't know
what that is. But obviously, I know what it is now.
By the time, it's confusing. Gigs are saying shit that man could go outside and get it.
You know what I'm saying?
And that's the difference between now and man will be, bro.
That made me like, this can work. Like, I could say it, you know what I'm saying? And break it down how I want to break it down. Like how I normally
as
talk.
As opposed to,
you hear me?
I might hear a song and I like the song, like a new song.
Yeah.
But you're talking about popping perks and sipping. I can't relate.
It's not me.
Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm not saying that's not you, but for man, that don't sound like where I'm from.
That's not man's culture, really.
Do you know what I mean? And it's like.
Bro, you see what people need to understand, even with the lean thing, like the pills and the lean. Like lean, is if I'm not mistaken, it's a Texas Houston thing.
Down South American thing.
So it's been around as long as we've been.
Yeah, of course, from
as long as we've been around.
That man in Philly were drinking.
This is what I'm saying, like beans
and that. But there was still crediting it to the South niggas.
But this is what I'm trying to say. So what I'm trying to say is that was never. A part of our thing. Because it's been around as long as we've been, me longer than me, and I ain't never seen no one pull up lean until recent times. You feel what I'm trying to say? And bro, what's it? What are we in 2020, fam?
Yeah.
Like, when did man really lean start really creeping over here? Yeah. What?
It's
what?
A new thing.
Nice. What? Yeah. What year? Like, really what year?
Say probably around what 2017, 18.
I'm gonna be real. Man went through a stage of drinking that bullshit, and that was 2016.
All right, so let's say 2015, 2016.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know how late that is to our culture, fam?
Even then, when man was doing it, it was kind of like raw. I was doing it. I'm gonna be real. I was doing it because the rappers that I listened to in America made it sound cool. So when I tried it, it's like, oh, cool. I'm doing it, man. After a few, I realized, raw, this ain't for man. It's dead, and it's actually. Fucking
cramps
up my
and all these
body,
things.
I
yeah.
can feel it. But even then, I wasn't trying to rap about it. Do you get it though?
I hear what I'm saying though. But how long? How late?
Now, that's
is that?
Still new. That's still
is that,
new.
No,
that's
what I'm saying. But that's what I'm trying to say. So if it's 2016, people been sipping lean from late 90s, early 2000s.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
How late are we to this thing?
Jump on.
Yeah.
That shows you that it's new culture.
Yeah, it's not our thing.
Yeah, that shows you that it's not our thing. You feel me?
Let's take it back and talk about that whole period of around 08 to, let's say, 2012.
Yeah.
Where there was like the lost times within the quote-unquote urban world.
Them days there, like you're talking about, the golden era was like probably had the least support and money. Do you get it? Bro, man was getting shows then. I'm getting paid £100, bro, for a show. But then...
There was a gas of having a show.
Oh, right. The fact that man can even step out. Yo, I'm going to go crowd. I've got money.
Now, secretly, if you got a show for a Bills now... Not that, obviously, you're not going to want to get that, but like, you wouldn't feel comfortable to say, bro, I ain't never had a show before, but a man's offering me £100 to spit, you feel me?
And back then, it was a luxury.
Do you get what I'm trying to say?
He was just doing it freely because...
Yeah, because it worked for the money. It's not like,
but then there you go. The essence has gone.
But now, man would be getting paid a couple bags here, so man kind of loses that kind of...
That hunger.
But
that,
if man was getting paid, the money we get paid now for doing it how we was doing it in the golden era, I reckon the quality of music would be much better.
Yeah,
because there's a lot of rappers from that era that are even around.
Yeah, and not even money was the reason why they decided to.
The man was on the road. Everyone's on the road. We're literally on the road. Everyone is on the road, bro. Because music ain't paying none of us.
So if you look at it like this, you might as well say, do you feel like some of the man then back then should have really fought harder?
Yeah, 100%. That's why man's here, bro.
So then that might be the downfall.
Bro, my favorite rappers, like half of them don't rap anymore, bro. Like I'm talking about like Paige.
Yeah.
Joe Black.
Yeah.
Like these are dons that man, do you know what I mean? They made me want to rap more.
Yeah.
Like, bro, yeah, my man's doing cool, I'm going to studio. Oh.
Boost, do you have any? That people that you know that were hardest.
Remember, my thing's a bit mad because I was away. But the time when I was too like Peckham Duff, like I weren't really.
But even then,
I'll call them out for you. Shocks, please.
There was
Shocks,
a bag of man from Peckham alone.
Yeah.
Like, hello.
Peckham had their own rap scene.
There was their own scene.
Like their own scene, bro.
Peckham was Fulton Heath before the Fulton Heath
scene. The slang and Ave. I'm telling you, bro. I remember I'm from Brixton, bro. So even for man to even.
But that's what I'm saying.
Accept that is mad, bro.
So, so obviously, my favourites back then, like, Shocks, Snap, like, Hollow, obviously. You know what I'm saying? Like, who else, bro? Like, just my man them really, like, you know what? Even like, even Tef, like, on the DVD shit. I told you all the time, you know that tune there, bro.
That's another thing. Traveling, you're talking about traveling.
Traveling, that tune there, oh, like, on this? Real Talk DVD was crazy.
I'm not to knock, bro, you come up in the era you come up in, innit? Like, you can't choose the era you come up. If I was to choose, I would have come out 5 years later. Mm. Did you get it? But had the artists that are around now, popping, quote, been around when it was our times when you had to be on a DVD. Forget YouTube.
Yeah, of course.
You had to be on a DVD.
Yeah, of course.
If you was out there, you was on a DVD. But watch this. The DVD man, the DVD man ain't checking for everyone. He don't have time to check for everyone.
Yeah.
If I come to a hood and there's 10 spitters there, I'm taking the top two or three because I got to go to the next hood.
Yeah.
So there weren't time for all of this. We cut out the bullshit at the door. Do you get it?
Yeah.
Now with YouTube, bro, I'm going to my garden, I'll make a video, it's up today. And it's like, it's just saturated.
You know, but then that's what it is. Where there's more ways in now, more,
and I'm not mad at that either. I'm not mad at that. Because, bro, the more opportunity for you, like I said, the better for me. Even if you're 12 years old, you come in the game today and you blow off, the better for me, bro.
Yeah.
Like, I don't mind if I've been in the game 10 years. If you're going to kick off the door, we're all doing it together.
It's like a gift and a curse. But one thing you can't do is hate and move like you're not in with the times.
That's like a... I wouldn't even say an old boy thing. I see man in the game for 2 years that we hate another man that just come out yesterday. Yeah, exactly. Like, you even, what have you done? Exactly. Do you know what I mean? Like, who gave you the keys?
I don't ever want to be the old boy. Like, my old boy's a hater.
Man wants to be the old don that
man fuck with him.
That the young boys love and grows gracefully. Like, my man did this. I remember when I was young and he didn't owe me nothing. He showed me this and da, da, da. That's who man wants to be. You get it? A man ain't talking about, I'm not talking about back in my day. Da, da, da. I'm still here, bro. I'm active. What do you want to do? You want to go on the booth? Let's go. Do you know what I mean? I'm not, I lead by example. I don't tell you all because in my day, I'm telling you now.
And some of them, even within the drill thing, even with the melody thing, man, I got bars in there. Man, I'm talking real shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, man, I've got it in there. Like, don't. There's a handful of them.
Yeah.
That you can see, because I listen to that. Because, bro, I'm gonna be real. I listen to drill because of like the energy that I get from it and that, and like it makes me feel like I'm back in. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? In that place when I'm not. But that's like my guilty pleasure. I can go there if I want to listen to a mad thing. I'm gonna go, yo. Do you know what I mean? But when I listen to some of them, I can say, bro, you could actually rap.
Yeah.
But you've chosen to make it like, see, like, Heady.
Yeah.
Heady One is a drill rapper, right?
Yeah.
But from the way Heady raps, I know, bro, you can rap, bro, or you've done this before.
You studied the art of rapping.
Do you know what I mean? And
but he just found what's worked for him and ran with it.
And that's how I differentiate, like, because there's a drill rapper that's just gonna say ching, 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 wash, like, cool, I ain't checking for you.
Yeah.
But when you're gonna break it down and, all right, cool, you got something, guys.
Yeah, man can fuck with it.
All right.
Let's talk about briefly you guys evolving with the game. when was the part of where you realised or you might have questioned, like, yo, am I out of touch? And if so, how did you keep in touch and stay relevant with this sound and what's popping?
You know what, yeah? You see, when I come out of Big, yeah, obviously, I was listening to my old shit. Like, not my old shit, my own music. Like, I don't work. Like, you get me? But I had to take, like, I come out of being like, just slapping, like, I don't give a fuck, like, let's get it on, like, kind of thing. But I had to realise, like, yo, like,
times change.
Times have changed. Like, you can't just come and be on some, maybe like when you're doing a freestyle or something like that, like, you kind of got to make a rhythm. I had to kind of clock that certain things, they might not be here and going to be here till, like, very, very long, but they're here right now. So to get through this period right now, you got to half, do you see what I'm trying to say? Work with what's going on.
Yeah, but you just never lose your way with that kind of thing. Right. Because, like, cool. So what I was going to say is because, like, the beats that, like a melody rapper or whatever might jump on, bro, I can jump on the same beat. I'm just not just going to sing. Yeah. So it's like, no one's forced to do any type of music.
Of course.
You do it because you want to. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's the music you choose to do. Whether it's because you've seen it work for a next man or you genuinely believe this is your type of music, cool, that's what you do. But for man, bro, like, the times don't change for me, bro, because the content is always going to be the same. I'm always going to give you that same, like, view from my point of view. Whether the beat is slow, fast, hard, soft, it don't matter. I'm always same with Boost. Like, the rhythm man sent me the other day and you... It's a rhythm that it's a tef rhythm, but you put your own thing on it. Man didn't want you to come and do, do you get it? And that's what I, as an artist, I feel like every artist should have that.
What did you guys listen to individually that helped with your re-emergence as artists?
Like me, I had to recognize Drill's here for, like, I'm not saying it's going nowhere, but it's here right now to stay, you feel me?
Yeah, because you wouldn't make a Drill song, but I've heard you say Drillers in your song, do you get it? So that's you.
You feel me? Like, letting man know, I
putting your spin on it, yeah. Without having to sound like that. Get it?
And if I fuck with somebody, I'ma get on some shit with them, you know what I mean?
Was there anyone specific that you might, like, say, for example, the younger generation from Peckham?
I had to realise that. You can't deny what's going on, fam. Like, you know what I'm saying? You can be stubborn as
much
as you want.
Stuck,
exactly, yeah.
That's when you're
stuck.
That's when you're
going to
do yourself.
You're
going to
do yourself.
How you helped sort of, like, merge and bring to us the forefront of the
60s. Even with that, okay, that's what it looks like from the outside.
Yeah.
But from the inside, it's like, cool. These men were rapping before Drill became about, but what is with them, man? Like, them men used to be hard on the Chicago scene.
Yeah. Yes.
Like, they put me onto it. Like, Def, listen to this, da, da, da. But before that, like, LD was always there when I was making my mixtapes. My man was always there in the house, just sitting there, watching, seeing how man does things. So when he came along with his Drill thing, I was like, bro, what? This is what?
Yeah. You man,
they schooled me on it. But their love for the game and record was always there before Drill. So it's like, all right, you lot do this? Cool. I'm going to bring that into what I do and show you lot my world. And that's how man incorporate it. So I wouldn't say, man, man helped bring it to the forefront, yeah, but I feel like they already had that knowledge musically in there.
All right, so when I was away, that's what I'm saying, when that Chicago shit hit, like, obviously...
2014, 15.
Yeah.
Now it was even earlier, 2012. Like, that's when I don't like, that's when
Yeah.
All right, cool. But I didn't really get onto, like, obviously I was hearing I don't like, but I weren't really hearing much of it, like. And then I got to one jail where man was just plugged in, you know, like that, and everyone was, but I don't really fuck with Sosa like that, to be honest. I just, like, I don't like, I like Sosa, love Sosa. Like, I love the bait ones really true, but then when I kind of copped the CD, I was like.
Oh, well, you got the album.
I was like, I need some more. Yeah. I'm jumping out and spazzing with the razz and like, I need some more. That's what I'm saying. When I got the Salt CD, finally Rich thing, I was like, nah, I need some more.
Oh, you need more of the West?
I needed more of the new East Coast, like, kind of.
So
yeah. Like, I was like, but remember, this is the first time I'm hearing someone rap like this. I'm thinking, nah, I need something a bit more.
Okay.
And then, like, maybe a Dirk. I got across some Dirk and that.
See, my thing was Dirk, old school Dirk, when he had the dreads.
Yeah, but
he got me on them, man.
What I'm saying is then the melody thing and kind of You know what I'm saying? So then when I heard it, then I got heavy on the Chirac, like you might listen to someone like G Herbo or something like that, that's kind of still rappy with it. Yeah. So boom, that's what, and then when I realized that they've kind of influenced the youths, them like the 6-7 and whatever the rest of them are, you know what I'm trying to say, like whatever Zone 2s and all these, you get me? Like, that's when I realized that if I fuck with this and this is what's mainly influencing the thing, I've got like, yeah, it's not I can't beat them, join them thing, but you have to
just embrace.
You have to embrace, bro.
Let me ask you this question in your both of your opinions as legends in this and people that are still heavily active in the scene right now. What are some of the attributes that you'll say craft your ideal rapper?